Apple released the first batch of Apple Intelligence features in their latest developer beta. I've used them for a week, and here are my favorites. First, you're going to be able to summarize basically everything. For example, in our notification center, if you receive a bunch of emails, in the past, they're all going to show up in one stack and you are going to see the preview of the first email. But now your phone is going to summarize everything into one message, showing you what are those emails about. Talking about individual email, instead of showing you the first one or two lines from the email, you're going to see a summary so you can quickly understand what that email is talking about. The group summary not only works for emails, but also for text messages. For example, you've received 10 messages from someone, or if you are in a group chat and there's a lot going on over there, now your phone is going to summarize everything and show you a summary of those text messages. Not only for text, but also for photos. Look at that. It's summarizing the photos I've received. This summarize function actually works throughout the whole system. For example, in our mail app, if I go to one of my emails, you can see here's a summarize button. If I click that, after a little bit, it's going to show me the summary of this long email. In addition, there's a prioritize section right on top of your inbox that I really like. Apple Intelligence is going to figure out what is the most important information you need to be aware of on that day. It's going to show you right on top. The summarize function also works in Safari. If I go to the reader mode and click the summarize button, it's going to show me the summary of this web page. It also works for phone call recording. As we know, in iOS 18, Apple finally allows us to record phone call. So after I receive my recording in my Apple Notes, I can open the transcript, click on the summary button. Here you go. Actually, you can summarize basically any text you've seen on the screen. No matter you're reading a Word document or PDF, or you just wrote some text by yourself, as long as you select all the text you want to summarize and then go to Writing Tools, hit Summary, you're going to see it right here. Before talking about the next feature, I want to mention, although I'm showing everything on my iPhone right now, Apple Intelligence feature is going to work on iOS, iPadOS, and macOS. My next favorite feature, Writing Tools. We just mentioned it in the last section. It can help you proofread, rewrite, change tones, create a summary, or something like that. So in the past, whenever I need to write some important things, after writing, I always need to copy it into Grammarly or ChatGPT. But now I don't need to go to third-party apps anymore. I can just select the things I wrote, click proofread. It's going to show me where my mistakes are and how to improve them. I can also go to rewrite. It's going to provide me a different variation. I can also change my tone to friendly or professional, so it's going to suit my situation a little better. I can also let it create a condensed version for me by clicking the concise button. In addition, I can create a short summary or key points or generate a list or table just like this. My next favorite feature, Smart Reply. After you receive a text message or an email, Apple Intelligence is going to detect what the question is and provide you a couple replies you can choose from. For example, I just got a text, "Do you need me to pick you up?" And here are my smart replies. Yes, no thanks. I just click on it, set, done. And here's an email. Do you want to go to the cinema after work? If I go to reply, here are the smart replies. I'd love to, I'm busy. And the cool thing is, in the email, if you click on the potential reply, it's actually going to write you a full sentence, just like this. How cool is that? My next favorite thing, new Siri. We are getting a new animation. That is beautiful. And now we can type to Siri. If we double-click the bottom of our screen, let me ask, what time is it in Paris? And now Siri understands the context a little bit better. For example, I'm directly switching to voice. So what's the weather like over there?
It's currently clear and 29 degrees in Paris, France, with air quality that's considered deteriorated.
Now it can also understand me a little bit better. For example, I'm on a web page and I want to send it to someone. Oh, by the way, I'm not even in Safari. Share this with Nick.
Ready to send it? It's sent.
Done. Now Siri can also understand vague questions. For example, I'm repeating myself or I'm thinking about something when I'm asking questions. Siri can still understand me. What time is it in Paris? Never mind. What's the weather like in Savannah? Actually, is it going to rain in North Charleston, South Carolina?
The National Weather Service has issued a storm surge warning, a tornado watch, and a flash flood warning. It's currently raining and 26 degrees in North Charleston, South Carolina.
The weather's really bad, but it made it. Now Siri can also provide me iPhone user guide. How can I find my missing AirPods?
To find your missing AirPods using the Find My app.
I also want to mention there's an even smarter Siri 2.0 in the works. So when that's ready, Siri's gonna use the data on your phone, for example, your mails, your messages, your calendars, and using those to generate a more customized and smarter response. Next favorite feature, reduce interruptions. It's a new focus mode. Apple Intelligence is going to determine if a notification is important or not. It will only notify you when the most important things come in. I've used it for a couple of days and I noticed it allowed most of my work emails come in and blog newsletters or notification from news apps. Oh, also, it thinks the tornado warning is important, so I guess that's working. My next favorite features have to do with the Photos app. Now it has a better search function. It can understand human language a little bit better. Me, wearing hat. Now please enjoy a bunch of random photos of me wearing hat. It can also search through videos. For example, I'm searching an item like TV. Go to a video, you can see the blue indicator on the progress bar that show you in which part of the video this item you are searching showed up, which is really nice. Now it can also create memory movies for you based on what description you write. Exploring Chicago, playing upbeat music. That's lovely. I'm going to send it to my mom. All right. That's all my favorite Apple Intelligence features so far. Please note that Apple has only released a couple of their Apple Intelligence features at this point. There will be more exciting features coming out throughout the year, such as Image Playground that can generate images, Gemoji that allows you to create avatars, Image Wand, Object Removal, Smarter Siri, Integrated ChatGPT, and more. I will definitely go check them out when they become available, so be sure to subscribe. I'm also curious, what's your favorite Apple Intelligence feature so far, and what are you expecting the most? Leave that in the comment. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Now, check out my iOS 18 review and see what's new. I will see you next time. Have a nice day!